Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: Palestinian prisoner released from Israeli detention after 65 days of hunger strike. Thousands of villagers arrested during protest against home demolitions in India. Argentine indigenous leader Milagro Sala completes 2,000 days in detention. And in our video section, we take a look at the state of siege in Haiti and the risk of foreign intervention. In our first story, a 28-year-old Palestinian prisoner was released from detention after 65 days of hunger strike. Ghadanfar Abu Atwan was first arrested by Israeli authorities 10 months ago. He was detained without charges or a trial under Israel's administrative detention system. As part of this, authorities are not required to present any evidence to justify arrest. Starting May 5th, Atwan launched a hunger strike to demand that he be released. On July 3rd, he also started refusing to drink water. His lawyer told AP that Atwan was arrested in October, released and then arrested again without ever being charged. The Palestinian Prisoners Club also stated that he was assaulted and abused in prison and sprayed with a substance that made it hard to breathe. As his health continued to worsen, he was shifted to Israeli Kaplan Hospital. Meanwhile, the Israeli Supreme Court recently cancelled his administrative detention. However, his lawyer stated that Atwan remained captive in hospital due to his health. Medical records dated July the 7th stated that he was noticeably weak, almost unable to speak and unable to move his lower limbs. It was confirmed on July 8th that he would be shifted to a Palestinian hospital in the occupied West Bank. As reported by Middle East Eye, Atwan has spent seven non-consecutive years in Israeli prisons since he was 19 years old. Rights group Adamir has estimated that 520 Palestinians are currently detained in Israeli military jails without charges or trial. Since 1967, almost 20% of the Palestinians, or over 800,000 people, have been arrested by Israeli forces. Within the occupied West Bank, at least 40% of the adult male population has been imprisoned at least once. We now go to India, where 10,000 families in the state of Haryana are at risk of losing their homes. The Supreme Court has ordered the demolition of encroachments on forest land in Faridabad. This was supposedly done to preserve the green cover of the Aravali Mountains. The municipal corporation has been given 6 weeks to implement the order, which will impact over 140,000 people. These encroachments refer to the Khori village, which is mostly composed of poor and migrant workers. They have lived in the area for decades after coming there to work in the quarries. While all mining operations were banned in 2009, the people continue to live in the village. The residents have stated that they were sold the land by local builders, often in collaboration with the forest department. They have also pointed to the high-rise buildings in the area, which have received no such orders. Following the Supreme Court's ruling on July 7th, all water and electricity supplies to the Khori have been cut off, with the demolition deadline drawing close. Residents have reported several suicides. Moreover, with temperatures over 40 degrees Celsius, 10 people have reportedly died due to lack of water. Meanwhile, the residents of Khori village have held regular protests amidst rising repression. Over 150 people are facing charges under the Disaster Management Act, incitement of violence, etc. Over 5,000 people were detained by Delhi police during a protest held on July 8th. A representative body of the villagers has now put forth four demands. They've asked that the demolition orders be revoked, affected families be compensated, and the officials responsible for suicides in the area be punished. The next hearing on the matter has been scheduled for July 27th. Our next story is from Argentina, where indigenous activist Milagro Sala has completed over 2,000 days in detention. The social leader was first imprisoned in January 2016 under right-wing former president Mauricio Macri. She was accused of instigation to commit crimes and disturbances. This was related to protests held outside a provincial government office against changes to the cooperative system. While her release was ordered, further criminal proceedings were initiated to keep her in detention. These were part of the Pibes Villoros case. Her organization, Tupac Amaru, was accused of fraud in relation to a housing construction program. Following her arrest, she was imprisoned at a prison in the Jujuy province. Her arrest was declared as arbitrary by the UN Working Group on Arbitrary Detention. The body argued that there had been consecutive allegations issued against Sala to ensure that she would be indefinitely detained. She was imprisoned in Jujuy till August 2017, after which she was placed under house arrest. She is currently facing charges in a total of 16 cases. The Argentine Supreme Court has yet to rule on an appeal she has filed in the Pibes Villoros case. If convicted, Sala will face 13 years in prison. Meanwhile, a protest camp was set up in the capital of Buenos Aires this week to demand that she be released. Various trade unions, social movements and civil society groups gathered in the Plaza de Mayo. Several cultural programs, forums and other events were held to denounce the persecution of political prisoners. And in our final story, we go to Haiti. Authorities announced on July 8th that 17 suspects in the assassination of de facto President Jovenel Moïse had been detained. Police Chief Leon Charles stated that 15 of them were from Colombia. Meanwhile, the Colombian government has said that at least 6 are retired members of its army. 2 other detainees are believed to hold dual US-Haitian citizenship. Charles further stated that 8 suspects were being pursued and 3 others had been killed. Meanwhile, interim Prime Minister Claude Joseph has announced a state of siege across Haiti. The army and police forces have been mobilized and movement has been heavily curtailed. Here is a video feature of the situation in the country.
The socio-political crisis in Haiti has been further deepened with the assassination of its president. In the early hours of July 7th, unidentified armed men attacked the house of Haiti's de facto president Jovenel Moïse and shot him dead. Haiti's interim prime minister and now acting president Claude Joseph confirmed the news in the early morning and declared a 15-day state of siege. On the evening of July 7th, the Secretary of State Communication, Franz Exantus, reported that the two suspects in the president's assassination had been arrested by the National Police in Pelerin. Hours later, in a press conference, the director of the Haitian National Police, PNH, Leon Charles, confirmed that the police captured two of the presumed assassins and killed four others. Claude Joseph also reported that he held a meeting with the core group, composed of the ambassadors of Brazil, Canada, France, Germany, Spain, the European Union, the United States of America, as well as representatives from the United Nations and the Organization of American States. He also informed that he spoke with the U.S. Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, about the assassination and the political crisis. Haitian civil society organizations and other progressive sectors have expressed concern about these meetings. They warned that Moïse's assassination could be used as a pretext to increase foreign interference and will far from alleviate the socio-political crisis in the country. They apprised that the core group has its own economic and geostrategic interests in the country. They also recalled that the core group supported Moïse's illegitimate government, whose presidential term constitutionally ended on February 7, 2021. The group also supported his unconstitutional plans to hold legislative and presidential elections and a constitutional referendum on September 26, 2021, despite the widespread popular rejection. Jubileo Sur Americas, a network of social movements in Latin America and the Caribbean, condemned Moise's assassination and pointed out that there are factors which indicate about the complicity or participation of the security forces in the assassination. Social movements of ALBA also stress that Moise's murder must not be the excuse for a new intervention in Haiti.
That's all we have time for today. We'll be back on Monday with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.